So we can move straight away now onto this masking fluid on the millstones themselves. Just making sure that we get rid of all of that. You can see how that's preserved perfectly, these elliptical shapes. And I've taken that masking fluid off the path in the middle distance as well. So we've now got some nice crisp edges of white paper. Let's mix some colours for the millstones. I'm using a number 8 brush. And I'm going to start with a little bit of Naples yellow. With a hint of rose madder in it. Almost like a pink colour. A bit more raw sienna and burnt sienna. I'm going to try and make the stones look a little bit more sunlit than they actually were, and that raw sienna and burnt sienna is a good combination for that. There's also quite a bit of moss and lichen on them, so we'll need a touch of green. Some oriolin with a bit of cobalt blue and just a little bit of that warm purple colour that we had in the sky at the outset. That's cobalt blue and rose madder. So I'm starting with the Naples yellow and rose madder, and we'll put that over all of these millstones. Don't need to worry about the base of them at the moment. It's mainly keeping that nice hard edge around the tops and sides. Now while that's still wet, I'm going to add a touch of the green. A little bit of the oriolin and cobalt blue. For where you get patches of moss and lichen. Let's have a little touch of the raw sienna and burnt sienna to brighten them up in one or two places. And just a hint of that purpley colour, that cobalt blue and rose madder, which gives us a nice warm grey when it mixes with the other colours on the paper. Touch more warmth into that one with the raw sienna and burnt sienna. Now there's some rocks here, which are all made of the same stone, so we may as well touch some colour in for those. If I leave a few little bits of white facing the sunlight, that won't hurt. And a bit of that purpley colour into them as well. And also a touch of the green. While they're still wet, so that I can make it look as though there's grasses and undergrowth creeping around the bottom of the stones, and to make them look really as though they've been laying there a long time, I'm introducing a bit more green just around the bottoms of them. A bit of water. It's always worth adding a bit of clean water into it just to keep it moist. It gives you longer to work wet in wet. And then we'll have a bit of that straw colour, that raw sienna with a touch of burnt sienna. Just letting it creep round the base of them. Get a bit bigger brush now, I'm going to a number 10. And I'm going to mix some more brown with burnt sienna and cobalt blue, a little bit thicker this time. And we'll start to work that in around the base of them as well. And it just creep in, taking advantage still of the wet in wet effect. I think we need a hint more red now. I'm going to put more burnt sienna into that mixture of raw sienna and burnt sienna. And let that creep in as well. Really bringing it down now to the bottom of the picture, to the bottom left hand side, and we'll have a touch more green to bring us over towards the path. Just leaving some white space at the moment for the path itself, and while I've got this mixture, we may as well put a bit of colour in to represent the right-hand side of the path as well. Bit of green, bit of orange. And we'll leave that to dry before we do some more work on the millstones themselves. We now need a couple of shadow colours. I'm going to start with a light shadow colour with cobalt blue and rose madder. And that actually is the same colour I used in the sky. That's quite important. This sort of gives your picture a harmony if your shadow colours tone in with your sky. Then I want a real dark colour for the dense areas, like in the holes in the millstones and the really densely shadowed parts of the stones, and that's ultramarine blue and burnt sienna. I'm starting with the stones furthest away, so I need a small brush, and this is a number two, some of the cobalt blue, rose madder and burnt sienna, and we'll start to bring a shadowing around the side of this one furthest away here. And you find what happens is the shadow from one stone will start to pick out the shapes of the stone next to it. We'll put a bit of the dark brown in around the base of that. A bit of dark for the hole in the centre of the millstone there. Really giving it some shape now. There's a stone here in front of this big millstone, so we'll put a bit of shadow in for that. I'm going to soften that in with a bit of clear water. And then darken it into this corner. A little bit of Naples yellow around there to suggest a few grasses and things leaking into it. And perhaps a bit of bright green, a bit of aureolin with cobalt blue. And really, it's the same method for all of them. The light's coming from the right-hand side, so you have to be consistent with where you put the shadows. Then these rocks, same sort of treatment, really. Get the shadow side of one rock to give you the light side of the one next to it, and just soften that colour in. And then go in with the dark. A few darks over here for a few more stones. And we'll leave that to dry.